Hey, hello friends, and welcome back to Quick Tips. So in today's video, we will be taking a look at how you can overlap components like a probe. So basically, we will be using an extension for this purpose, the link to which you can find in the description. So I have created a new project. You can see, first of all, I will select my screen component and change the alignment to center. And I will hide the options menu and change the screen title to something. Now let's take a look at the design that we will be making in our video. So the design is quite simple. We have three buttons, two labels and a slider at the bottom of the video. And as you can see, this black container is the video. You can use a video layout extension by Atom Developer or my extension. You can find the link below to create something like this. You can use that extension to create a video player in a view. So the design is quite simple. You can make this design using a decoration component or animation utilities. But the problem with that is when you have other devices, like they have some other dimensions, like they can have a longer height or they can be wider. So in that case, our design will fail. If you're using decoration component or animation utilities, there are probabilities that your design will fail. And moreover, that design accomplished using animation utilities or decoration utilities is quite difficult, and most of the users are unable to understand. But using the extension is quite simple. Again, you can find the link to that extension below in the description. Now let's head back to our Creator Studio. And here I will import the extension that is Relative View. So why Relative View is the name? Because it is based on the relative layout of Android provided as a built-in component. Relative layout is used in Android Studio to create layouts that contain overlapped components. So the extension is based on that component. Now, first of all, we will drag a horizontal arrangement or a vertical arrangement, that doesn't matter. So we will keep this as our video layout. So I will change the color to black and bits to be a fill parent. And now I will change the height. I will keep the height and width to be a fill parent for a moment, and I will rename this component to our video container. Now I will make it non-visible, and then I will drag a vertical arrangement or a horizontal arrangement, both will work in our case, and rename it to main container. So this main container is the container that will hold all the views, our video container, our buttons, our labels container, slider, etc. So this is the main container that will be used by the extension. Now I will change the width to be a fill parent, and then the background color I will set it to be a none. And for height, I will change it to be a 35%. Now I will change the color to see what's happening actually on the builder. Now in our design, we have three buttons in a row. So for this purpose, we can drag a horizontal arrangement and set it width to fill parent, and we can change the properties to be center. Now I will remove the background color, and now I will add three buttons. Now I will remove the background color, and for text font size I will choose 24, and now here I will say /10. So I am using a material icon here, and here I will change the color to be a white. So now as I am designing, I will change the color to be something that is visible. After that, when we will overlap our components, we will change our button's color to be white. So this is our play button. So now our buttons are completely designed. So I will change the color back to white. As you can see in our design, we have buttons as white colored. So I will change all the color to white. So our buttons container is done. So I will rename this horizontal arrangement to be a buttons container. Now again I will hide this so we can design properly, and at the end we will just show our components. Now one more thing we will do here is add a horizontal arrangement for labels and a slider. So first we will drag a vertical arrangement, set its width to be a fill parent, and alignment we will change it to be a center. Now the background color is obviously going to be a none. Here I will drag another horizontal arrangement. So basically we will add these labels inside the horizontal arrangement and the slider in our vertical arrangement. Change the alignment to center and the color is going to be a null. Now it's time to add our labels. So I will add two labels and set their width to be a fill parent. And for the second label, I will change the text alignment to be a right. So here I will change the text to be 00. So in this label, you can show the actual duration of the video. But since we are focusing on the design only, so I won't. I will just hard code these values. Now I will change the text color here and set it to be white, and then we will add our slider and I will change the width to be a fill parent, and max value is going to be 100, main value is going to be 1, and thumb position is going to be 1. So our slider is at the initial position. Now I will change the color right to be a light gray, so it is more visible on our video, as you can see here. So now our second component is also done. So I will rename this arrangement to be labels container. So now our design is complete. So I will make everything visible, our buttons container and our video container. So let's open up our block section, and when the screen initializes, we will call a method called decorate. So we will name this method to be decorate. So inside our method, we will add all the functionality. So if you open up this extension, you will see three main blocks. The first one is create layout. So this is our main block. If you can use other blocks without this block, you will get runtime exceptions. So obviously you will make a layout first and then add components to that layout. So first we will create a main layout that will hold other views. So we will use our main container for this purpose, and then we will add other views to this main container. Now first of all, we will add our video container. And now let's open up our blocks and see the gravities. So we have lots of gravities, and we can also combine these gravities by using a combine. I will add the video container in the center. So let's refresh and see what's happened. So as you can see here, our main container is created, and inside our main container, the video container is added. Now we can add other components as well. Now let's add other layouts as well. So we will drag another add view layout. So here we will add our buttons container. So drag a buttons container instant block, and we will again add this buttons container in the center. So let's refresh and see. So as you can see here, our buttons are at the center. So if you are using any other device, you will still see all these buttons at the center. So this is the main feature of our extension. It keeps the layout as it is in all devices. So you don't have to worry about different screen sizes. So our last component, which is labels container, we will add that as well. So I will drag a labels container block, and we will now add this at the bottom. So our layout is complete now. You can see just small number of blocks, and you achieve a fluid and a dynamic layout that is quite difficult to achieve using animation utilities or decoration component. So this extension has a combined block which we will take a look at now. So for this combined block, let's add a checkbox. So this is just for example purpose, and I will change the text box color to something that is visible on black. So I will change it to, let's say, blue. And now let's use the combined block. So we will drag our add view component block, and now I will use the checkbox as the component. And now we will use our combined gravity block. Suppose you want this checkbox to be at the top left corner of the main layout. So this can be achieved by a top and then a left. So what this does is align this component to top left of the main layout. So if we refresh here, you will see that the component is at the top left of the main layout. So you can use this combined block to combine gravities like bottom right, bottom center, or something top right, bottom left, etc. So let's change it to bottom right and see what happens. And now our checkbox is at the top right corner of our video layout. So using this extension, you can achieve really complex UIs that are quite difficult to make using animation utilities or the decoration component. So don't worry if you didn't understand anything. You can ask me in the comment section, and I will be posting new videos regularly from now on. So there have been lots of changes in the builder. We have new extensions, and I have lots of new ideas that I will be sharing with you guys. So stay tuned for the next videos, and thanks for watching.